गम रहता है। ओ जाने क्यों फिर भी दिल कहता है जी ले जरा, जी ले जरा, कहता है दिल जी ले जरा। है हम सफर है हम नवा, वापस जी ले चाहत भी है। फिर दिल के दिल से पुल क्यों टूटे हैं, क्यों हम जीने से इतने रूठे हैं। आदिल के दरवाजे हम खोले, ओ सफर है हम नवा, आपस जी ले जरा।
हेलो एवरीवन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अ वेरी हैप्पी न्यू ईयर टू ऑल माय सब्सक्राइबर्स। या सो इट्स बीन अ वाइल सिंस माय लास्ट ट्यूटोरियल, so that's why I just decided to do this wonderful song. Now before beginning the tutorial, I have a very honest request for all of you, all my subscribers, rather whoever is watching this video. In general, you know, for example, right now I just saw a couple of tutorials for this particular song, you know, just to see what others have posted. I'm really sorry to say, but you know, people have put up a lot of crap out there. Okay, I'm not trying to do any competition out here, but all I'm trying to tell you is you have to be aware. Okay, you have to be very careful when you are actually viewing any listening to any tutorial, even for my tutorial. If you think something is not correct, you can let me know, definitely, you know. But you have to listen to the song at least 50-60 times and then see a tutorial, and you'll see the difference. Okay, because I listen to the song at least 200 times before coming up with a tutorial. Okay, I literally scrutinize each and every note in that song. I try to. I'm not saying that I'm 100% correct. Okay, but if you will find the closest match, and you have got, if you see my profiles, like all my other videos, people have similar comments that if they listen to original and if they listen to my tutorial, they can actually correlate because it's very similar. All I'm trying to say is, you know, don't get misguided by some of these tutorials. Okay, some of them are very good. I'm not saying that all the tutorials are bad. There are many good tutorials, but you have to be very choosy, right? Because you're going to spend a lot of time on the tutorial. So you know, make sure you understand the tutorial very well, and for that matter you need to listen to the song many number of times. Only then you'll be able to judge and decide which one is the best one and which one is the most authentic one, right? As far as this song is concerned, there are major sevens used, there are add 13s used, add 9 used, there are different types of chords. And in simple language, let me tell you one thing. For layman, major song, happy sound, minor sound or minor chord is saddish sound. These are not the only two emotions in life. There are n number of emotions, right? And that's why the inventor has created so many chords. So you have to use it. If you don't use it, you won't be able to give the justice to the song, you know. So I just wanted to give my two cents on this particular topic. So let's begin the tutorial.
Begin with this tutorial quickly, the chords for this song.
All right, so this song is in A minor scale, okay, and all you have to basically remember is this A minor chord. I think you must be already knowing this chord by now. This is how you play A minor, okay? If you don't know, you can actually go to YouTube and just search for basic chords. That's how you can find. So the chords for this tutorial, for this particular song, A minor add 9. So it's very simple. I've explained that in my previous tutorials. All you have to do is just remove your index finger. This is A minor add 9. Okay? Then you have E minor. E minor is like this. Then you have B minor, which is like this, or you can even play it here. But I would suggest you play it open, like this. D minor, then you play G major. Then there is one more chord, obviously there are two more chords, which is the beauty of this song, that is F major 7. I don't want you to bar F major 7. This is how you can, F major, basically all you have to do is, if you know how to play F, okay, then just play F without barring, and instead of covering two fingers, it's easy, you just have to cover one finger, that is your second string, and the note C, the first fret. Second string, first fret, and this is what you play. This becomes F major 7, okay, and the next chord, the last chord, another important one is, you just, you know, move your fingers down by two frets, all the way down, okay, and same composition what you had in F, just make it exactly like this and play this, okay. This one is G6 add 13, or it's also E minor 7, okay. Don't worry about it, it might sound complicated, but all the way you can remember is it's F major 7, and you can say it's basically G6 add 13. It's F and G. It is not F major and G major. Okay? Please, do not even think about playing major scale, major chords. There is like huge difference between F major and F major 7. Okay? So make sure you understand that very well. That's for the chords. Rhythm, okay? I would prefer just a downstroke, because this song is a very silent and very touching and soft song. Okay? There's nothing like, you don't have to strum it very harshly. Just simple downstroke will do. Three, four, one, two, three, four, five, one, two. And then, during the chorus lines, so G, G laser. This is a slow rock. So slow rock, if you want to know slow rock how to play, it's very simple. It's just hold A minor, okay, and it's tightening like this. Down, 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 up, up, down, 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 up, up, down, 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 down. So it's down, 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 up, up, down, 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 up, up, down, down. So when you start the song, it's basically, so two strokes with A minor, then two strokes with A minor add 9, again another two strokes with A minor. So basically two strokes with A minor, two strokes with A minor add 9, another two strokes with A minor, another two strokes with A minor add 9. So totally 8 strokes you have to play, okay? Then this is played twice, and then you start the song. So that's E minor. Same thing. Then D minor. E minor. Oh, jaane phir bhi phir kyun kehta hai? G. Kehta hai. Okay, you have to break here. Then G le zara. So here, this is where you can actually start slow rock. So it's basically A minor, F, G6 add 13. Okay, so it's like this. G le zara. two strokes of A minor, then F major stern,
G, Re, Zara,
and E minor. So two strokes of A minor, two strokes of F major 7, two strokes of G6 at 13, and two strokes of E minor. Okay?
G, Re, Zara, G, Re, Zara.
Now, one thing I forgot to tell you is F major 7, you're not supposed to play the 6th string. Okay? This is void. So only first 5 strings.
G, Re, Zara, G, Re, Zara.
Again, another time. Now, A hum suffer.
A hum suffer.
A hum suffer. The sequence is D minor twice, E minor twice, F major 7 twice, and G6 add 9:30. This is once. Ah, pass, whatever. The second line.
Pass, yeah.
So A pass A, D minor twice, E minor twice, and then break it there.
G, Re, Zara, la, la, la.
The same intro pattern.
La, 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 la.
Verse part, okay? So the verse again starts from A minor. So D minor. Phir bhi isme E minor.
Ye raah,
ye raah thi second D minor.
Ye raahat bhi hai.
I'll play again.
Hai zindagi, mana dard bhar.
D minor.
Phir bhi isme ye raahat bhi hai.
Same chord composition for the next two lines. Now break it on E major, okay? E major. Or you basically you can even play E7, okay? If you can play E7, well and good. Otherwise, E major also fine. You can play E7. That might sound more realistic. So play E major and then put your pinky on the second string, third fret. Okay, so now listen to these chords correctly, okay? Just check this out. E major 7, E7, and so one stroke of E major, or E7, then D minor. A minor, okay? Same thing. Another D minor. After that, another D minor.
Dil ke darwaze hum khole. Oh, hum dono ji bhar ke roye.
That's G. Again, we have to break on G. So this.
Dil ke darwaze hum khole.
I think this is the same as.
धड़कन धड़कन एक गम रहता है.
So if you refer those chords, exactly same.
आ दिल के दरवाजे हम खोले. ओ आ हम दोनों जी भर के.
ये कौन जी?
रोए जी ले जरा.
And जी ले जरा chords I've already explained. So that's what I would suggest. Try to find out. Try to first learn all the chords properly. Play those F major 7, the G which I explained you, G6 at 13. Okay. Listen to the chords properly. When you are playing the chords, you have to listen to it. Okay, and you should get that similar sound. Okay. Major 7 chords are specifically used by Ram Sampath to create that particular mood which he wanted to create. Okay. So that is very important that you play them properly. All the strings should sound correctly. It's not that only, especially I've seen when you play these bottom notes, it sounds very muted and it won't sound good. Okay. So play the chords properly. First, just play all the chords properly. Okay. Very slowly. This song is a slow song, but you can even note it down. Play very, very so slowly. Then when you are able to get all the chords, okay, then you can try. I mean, there is hardly any rhythm, okay, so basically your one of the most exercise is listening. This song requires a lot of listening. Listen to the song again and again, then try to play with the song, okay, and then try it out. All right, so good luck. Let me know if you have any issues.